then Jimmy Fly struck a stone cold ham. Enough, better get together, put your hands in the sky. Stick 'em up, punk, hit them low, hit them high. Now I'm the bad boy that you invite for dinner. Ain't got no manners, cause I eat with my fingers. Lost boys terrorize the neighborhood, and hounds at the basket will be up to no good. So come on, come on, everybody keep checking us. Coming with the funk.
Get down now.
Bring it on, bring it on, bring it on.
They haven't been fighting in more than a decade. Haven't been fighting fair, that is. Sorry. I don't want to talk smack about Fall Out Boy right there. The Takeover, The Break's Over, all the way from 2007. That is a request, by the way. Ryubabin over at Twitch requested for that track right there. And saying hello to his friends, their friends. Shout out to Ben, Wensie, Dennis, and Hector. Thank you so much for requesting that track right there. Anyway, my name is Mikey. Welcome to the second hour of this edition of Friday Madness. It's 1:10 on the clock. We got a special guest over here.
Hi, my name's Andy.
You can put the headphones on. You know you can. It's okay. We got Andy right here. We were talking while, you know, off air. And I was really curious, like, we were having a conversation on, like, the type of content that you consume when you're online. Yes. So what normally, first of all, which platforms do you spend the most time on?
So, you know, I'm part of Gen Z. So, of course, it's TikTok and Instagram.
I think. Yeah. And it is like, I'm not on TikTok. I just spend like a tiny amount of time on Instagram. So my Instagram is pretty much just like all travel stuff. What's on your Instagram?
Usually celebrities, like...
You can get closer to the mic, by the way.
Oh, like celebrities. Singers, yeah, actors, yeah.
What's the hot topic right now for celebrities?
Ooh.
Oh, what are you following? The last one I followed was like the Taylor Matt Healy thing,
yes,
but that just ended. So what's hot right now actually for celebrities?
Actually, I'm not sure because I'm mostly on like the Taylor Swift side as well.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Yeah, I think, okay. I have actually, here's what I think about the Taylor thing. I don't like Matt Healy for Taylor, but I also think that she's a grown woman who can date whoever she wants. And the fans telling her that, like, Taylor shouldn't date Matt. He's gross. So, like, yeah, let Taylor decide.
Yeah, I agree. I'm not a huge fan of, like, Matty Healy. But
Yeah.
She's, like, in her 30s, so I think...
Exactly. Actually, before we move on to the music again, let me ask you one more thing. So before I go to bed, I just consume a little bit of content, but there's always that one post that makes me go like, you know what? That's enough internet for today. Let me put this down and go to sleep. What is that post for you?
Oh, probably like if I see a TikTok of someone like being really unhinged, sharing something like kind of disturbing about themselves.
Oh, no.
That's it.
Yeah. But that's so engaging sometimes. Do you go through the comments or do you just like, you know what? That's enough. I don't even want to see what people are talking about.
It depends, but I'm really nosy, so I go through the comments.
That's the fun part. Anyway, so Andy, since this is your radio debut, by the way.
Yes.
What do you have a request that we can that you would like to hear on the air?
So I heard we're listening to 90s. Y2K, yeah. So
yeah.
I'd like to ask if you have any Green Day.
Green Day, absolutely. Yeah. Do you want me to choose, or you just want to?
You have Basket Case.
Basket Case, nice choice. Okay,
thank
we got
you.
Basket Case right here. You're tuned in to Yesterday's Hits Today, Friday Madness 90s, 2000s with Mikey and Andy. We got Green Day from 1994.
Do you have the time to listen to me whine about nothing and everything all at once? I am one of those melodramatic fools, neurotic to the bone, no doubt about it. Sometimes I give myself the creeps. Sometimes my mind plays tricks on me. It all keeps adding up. I think I'm cracking up. Am I just paranoid? Am I just stuck? I went to a shrink. To a whore, he said my life's a bore. Joke with my wife.
Yesterday's It's Today, Friday Madness. Love that song. Sixpence None the Richer from 1998 with Kiss Me. Saying hello to Tiki Tiki Tombo for requesting for that one over at Twitch. You can send in your request, by the way, over at twitch.tv/magic899tv. You're still out here with Mikey. We're just halfway through the show, actually. And we have Andy over here. Hi, Andy.
Hello.
And we were just talking about how she saw the Spider-Verse movie, and I haven't yet, but I heard it was pretty good. What did you think?
Oh, it was really, really good. You have to see it.
Yeah, I have to see it. I was meaning to watch it, but you know, I got sick, and I was super tempted to just get it on, just watch it online, but you have to watch it in cinemas.
Yes, for sure.
First of all, like, I heard the movie was long.
Yeah, about 2 hours, 30.
2:30. You know, that's long for an animated film, by the way. That's Marvel length. What did you like more between the first and second Spider-Verse movie?
That's a really hard decision to make. But I'll have to say the second one, actually.
The second one?
Yes.
Okay, now I really got to watch it because the first one was incredible.
For sure.
I was telling you off the air that I actually, like, my degree, my college degree is in animation, and when I first saw Spider-Verse, when I walked out of the cinema, what I thought about was, this movie is different. And it really is. Like, I don't know if other people noticed this, but ever since Spider-Verse came out, animated films started looking different. Because, like, before Spider-Verse, everything looked like Pixar or DreamWorks, and there was a look, right?
Yeah.
There was like, it had the 3D look. But then Spider-Verse came out and it looked like real comics. And it was stylized pretty much. Have you seen the Puss in Boots movie?
Oh, the recent one?
Yeah.
Not yet.
It's really good. And also, like, I saw the trailer for the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles.
Oh,
like,
yes.
They look different. Like, start noticing that from now on. Like, when you see an animated film, like, oh, it's stylized. It's not like the traditional Pixar looking one.
Wow. So
yeah. Anyway, that it's really like, I'm glad we were in this point in time where animated films can look like that. Anyway, did you watch on IMAX, by the way?
I'm not sure, actually.
Okay. Because I'm kind of want to save. I haven't checked yet, but I kind of want to watch in 4DX. Have you ever tried 4DX before?
Not yet. I really want to, though.
It depends on the person, I think. Because you know what happens in 4DX, right? Like, yeah, you wear the glasses, but the seats move. Like, there's air, like, you know, blasting to your face, like a little bit of mist. I watched it when I watched the Avatar Way of Water. Super fun. Like when you're underwater, it does feel like, whoa, I'm underwater. When you're flying, like, oh, there's wind blowing in my face. I love it. It's not for everybody. Some people may think that, you know, like, it makes me sick, like the motion sickness, but I love it.
Wow. I have yet to watch, actually, Avatar.
Yeah.
I haven't seen
it. It's super fun. I know it's like the CGI is incredible. I know that a lot of movies have CGI these days, but like Avatar Way of Water is like next level. Anyway, super recommend it. And you've seen like the movie several times. Man, it's funny. You're not the first person I've met who mentioned that they've seen Spider-Verse like that many times.
Yes, it's so incredible. I mean,
you mentioned that you love it for the new characters. Which two characters are we talking about without spoiling?
So it'll be Spider-Punk, amazing. Miguel O'Hara.
Uh-huh.
And I forgot the name of the other one, but another new character from, I think, the city Mumbatan.
Yeah.
Yes, those three specifically.
Man, I'm going to watch it this weekend. Spider-Verse in cinemas, still in cinemas. Watch it. Everyone says it's good. I have yet to meet a person who says that it's like a not good movie. Anyway, Andy, you've convinced me. And so we're going to do this thing. You're going to introduce a song. And you have to do it. You remember how to do it?
I believe so. I wrote it down.
That's okay, great. Okay, we're going to play the song in 3, 2, 1.
This is Can't Stop by the Red Hot Chili Peppers on Yesterday's Hits Today, Friday Madness on Magic 89.9.
Hey, you did it. Enjoy. Can't Stop, Won't Stop. Yesterday's Hits Today, Friday Madness. Stay, keep it locked.
Use my hands for everything with steering. Can't stop the choose not a life of imitation. Distant cousin to the reservation. Defunct the pistol that you pay for. Dispunk the feeling that you stay for. In time, I want to be a best friend. Eastside love is living on the west end. Knocked off before you better come to. Don't die, you know the truth is some do. Go write your message on the pavement. Burn so bright, I wonder what the wave meant. Kickstart to go, then generate her. Sweet talk, but don't intimidate her. Can't stop the gods from engineering. Feel no need for any interfering. Your image in the dictionary. This life is more than ordinary. Can I get you maybe even three of these? Coming from a space to teach you of the Pleiades. Can't stop the spirits when they need you. This life is more than just a read-through.